Thank you so much for coming tonight. Both Vince and I are so thrilled to be performing with this wonderful Bohuslän band, these incredible musicians, so dedicated, so talented. And Vince had the pleasure of working with them a few times before, right, Vince?
Yes.
A few times. And he invited me, he said, you want to go to Sweden in the close to winter time? And I said, sure. It really is a pleasure to be here. And as Vince said, we made this really gorgeous recording, in my opinion, not because of my singing, but really because of Vince's writing. I'm going to talk a little bit more about him later, but I think I might just do a little bit now. I consider Vince to be one of the great composers of my generation. We are close in age, and I loved his compositions before I even loved him as an arranger, but I had a chance to work with him a few times. And for this project, he invited me to collaborate with him. And as he said, we looked for repertoire that would be new to us, but also maybe known to some people. And we, of course, went to the major composers, Gilberto Gil, Djavan, Ivan Lins. And of course, we couldn't forget Antonio Carlos Jobim, the composer of Chega de Saudade, Garota de Ipanema, Corcovado, and so many others. I mean, millions of songs, really hundreds of them. But we came upon this piece. I suggested it to Vince. It's a piece that's only been recorded once. And it's an important piece for Jobim because he had left Brazil. He moved to the United States. He was living in New York City. He had been working already with Sinatra. He made two records with Frank Sinatra, 71 and 72. This music, he was living in New York City, and I think thinking bigger, more expansive, you know, just larger compositions, not so much about songs, and not so much about love as in relationship between men and women or two people, but love for nature and love for country and love for myths and stories. So he decides to write this through composed piece, and it's called Machita Pere. And in it, the story goes as if we are looking at the life of one man that represents all of us. His name is John, João, which is the most common name in Portuguese, and maybe in many places in the world, right? Many other places. But João is the common man, and João must leave his place, his birthplace, and go looking for a better life. But it's really a sort of a metaphor for what we all have to do. We have to leave the people we are and travel through the world and go through it, sort of this existential journey in life in order to become better and to become men and women and to grow, really. So João leaves, and this is the trip. And Jobim in it does something magical. He goes through all the tonalities in music, all 12 keys, and it's really a journey. And it's a beautiful dialogue, I believe, between myself and the orchestra. The orchestra has much just these beautiful moments and interludes and lines. And Vince's arrangement is sublime. This is Machita Pere.
Thank you.
vida, encontrando a morte pela meia rosa no quadrante norte. João,
a vida de dia das mortes, o estranho chamado João.